All right, so far we have learned about ionic compounds and covalent compounds. Now, let's talk about the differences between these two. Yeah, they have different properties, right? The differences in the way they form bond, one is sharing, one is lose electron and gain electron, become ion, lead to many unique physical property, and they actually have different properties, right? For example, right here, so we have limestone. This is an example of ionic compound called calcium carbonate, right? And we have olive oil that is as an example of a covalent compound, okay? So start with the property. So limestone, and you guys know, a hard crystallite composition, right? It's a solid. High melting points and high boiling points, all of them, these are ionic bonds, okay? These are characteristic of ionic bond, ionic compound. Now, covalent compound, soft solid, usually liquid, right? So a soft solid like butter. You can think about, like, imagine butter. Low melting point and low boiling point. That's why it's usually liquid at room temperature or gas at room temperature. Okay. And for covalent compound, we represent a covalent compound using the molecular formula, right? Which is the molecular formula represents the actual number of each atom in the molecule. For example, CO2, there's actually one carbon, two oxygen. CO, one carbon, one oxygen. Yeah. Water, H2O. Okay, this is a chemical formula of a covalent compound is molecular formula. Right. However, in ionic compound, sodium chloride doesn't just stay at one sodium ion and one chloride ion. It stay as a lattice. A new word for you. It's an array of ions. Yeah, array of ions called lattice. Right. So it's just small amount of the whole, like, table salt in your spoon. Okay, so ionic compound exists as a ray of ions called lattice. All right, write this word down somewhere. We'll come back to the word lattice later. All right, if you want to, like, compare to covalent compound, all right, we use the molecular formula to represent an actual number of each atom in the molecule. But you can do that with sodium chloride. Sodium chloride stay like in an array of ions called lattice. It's just there are too many of them. If you want to represent the whole number of each ions in an ionic compound, you probably have to do this. Like sodium, I don't know how many of them, you have to go count it. So I mean, it's no one gonna count it, right? But what we know is sodium and chlorine, they bind together with 1-to-1 ratio. So we just use sodium, one sodium, one chloride, to represent the whole sodium chloride. And this formula we call empirical formula, which represent the smallest whole number ratio. Yeah, you can't represent the whole thing. We just use the empirical formula for ionic compound. Okay, so that's the difference. So boiling point, melting point are different. Ionic compound higher, covalent compound lower. Ionic compound usually a solid at room temperature. Covalent compound usually a gas or liquid at room temperature. Well, low boiling point, low melting point. Right. Covalent compound use a molecular formula, but ionic compound is so hard to show the molecular formula. So they don't even exist as a molecule. They exist as lattice. Okay. So we use the empirical formula instead. All right. Another different property. Let's go to the next video. Electrolyte and non-electrolyte.